We have discussed about the administrative measures adopted by Alauddin Khalji under Muhammad Tughlaq. What all measures has adopted by Alauddin Khalji? It all was a successful one. He effectively controlled his administration. The rise of the means the price of the goods. He constructed a garrison town. What was the name of the garrison town he constructed?
Siri.
He constructed a garrison town for his and he effectively controlled, he collected the taxes from the people. He collected the taxes, 50% of the production he collected from the peasants, and it was enough for him to manage manage the soldiers and feed the soldiers in cash, and the the soldiers would buy the things from the merchant, so there would be a chance for the merchants to increase the prices of the things. But he appointed officials to control, to check the activities of the merchants. And he effectively,
if they had
everything,
if they had raised the price, they would be punished.
And also the sultan said to write the price in one board.
Gautam, that we have discussed about the corona period and all.
Okay.
It was not instructed by Alauddin Khalji. He controlled the prices. He controlled the prices, and if any merchants, if they increase the prices of the goods, they will be punished. So he took an effective measure, or he took very effective measures to control the rise of the prices. But on the other hand, what all measures were adopted by Muhammad Tughlaq? It all became
a failure.
He did not construct a garrison town, a new garrison town for the soldiers.
He made one new coin.
First for
he made a new capital, Daulatabad.
Rather than constructing a new garrison town,
he made another capital.
He built a new capital in the south. What was the name of that?
Daulatabad.
And he asked the people from Delhi to move to Daulatabad.
Yes, ma'am. But then later they were sent back to
Daulatabad, and the soldiers were deployed in Delhi. Then the other one, children, listen to me. He collected the taxes. Like Alauddin Khalji, from the same place, 50% of the production, but that was not enough for him to maintain a huge army. So what he
ma'am, so he made token currency.
So he levied additional taxes.
And also made a new token currency.
So it became a huge burden for the peasants. Already they were paying 50% of the total production. And also, the Sultan levied additional or the extra taxes. So all become a burden for the peasants. So it created famine. That incident coincided with the famine. Famine means scarcity of
scarcity.
Then other important administrative measure he has adopted, that he introduced a new token currency made up of cheap metals. So people during this century, they were very smart.
They used this for taxes.
They collected the gold and
silver. Ma'am, they gave this as taxes.
Yes.
They saved the silver and gold coins and gave the people tax collectors these coins.
Yes. They saved their gold and silver coins, and they paid paid the tax to the government by using this. Okay, by this token currency. So all these measures, okay, was adopted by Muhammad Tughlaq. Everything went, okay, it all went a big flop. Okay, and chroniclers praised Alauddin Khalji for his effective measures. He controlled prices of the goods. Okay, he controlled very effectively. He effectively withheld the campaign against Mongols. Okay, but what about Muhammad Tughlaq? He disbanded his army. Okay, he disbanded his army and asked the people to shift back again to Delhi. Okay, yes. And the peasants, okay, the peasants in Ganga Yamuna Dob, where he collected the taxes, they started rebellion. Rebellion means protest. Yes, protest against the Sultan, and token currency also was recalled. What do you mean by recalled?
Token was taken back.
See, children, Muhammad Tughlaq, he recalled the token currency. Okay. Okay, children.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so yes. Just we have compared the rulers, okay, the different rulers of different dynasties, the important rulers of two different dynasties, that is Khalji dynasty, Alauddin Khalji, and Tughlaq dynasty, Muhammad Tughlaq. Okay, we compared what all measures his he disbanded his army because his campaign against Kashmir was a failure. So he Muhammad Tughlaq, he increased the number of soldiers, and why he shifted the people from Delhi to
Ma'am, he wanted to fight
against
the Mongols.
Mongols. Okay, that is the only reason why he introduced many changes. Okay, he introduced many changes only because he wanted to lead a military campaign against the Mongols. He wanted to attack Transoxiana.
Mongols.
Invade Transoxiana.
Yeah, Transoxiana was under the control of
Mongols.
Okay, Transoxiana was under the control of Mongols. So he wanted to attack Transoxiana. Okay, he wanted to capture Transoxiana and he wanted to attack Mongols. Okay, that is the only reason he made these many changes in his administration, but all become very failure. He do not continue the fight or military campaigns against the Mongols. So he disbanded the army. Okay, because the peasants were suffered a lot. Okay, token currency, they paid this cheap metals as stock taxes. So all these measures become a complete failure. Okay, children, do you have any doubt? Have you gone through the textbook? Have you read it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay,
yes, ma'am.
Do you have any doubt?
Yes, ma'am, I read it. Now,
unless we can continue the portion. Do you have any doubt, children?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Children, I do want to ask some students, that Ligel, Dion, Manish, Mariam, Felix, all of you turn on your video, please. Why you people are hiding? I don't think see, children, today onwards, okay, when I put the absentee's name, I will put the name as non-video participants. Okay, children, so we'll continue. Then, now, we have discussed about Khalji dynasty, slave dynasty, Tughlaq dynasty, and all. Now we will discuss
Sayyid dynasty.
Yes, now we will discuss the Sultan.
Sultanate
15th century. Okay, that is Sayyid and the Lodi dynasty. Okay, children, Sayyid dynasty. The founder of Sayyid dynasty was Khizr Khan. Okay, Khizr Khan. Khizr Khan was the founder of Sayyid dynasty. Okay.
Sayyid.
Khizr Khan was the governor of Firoz Shah Tughlaq. Okay. Firoz Shah Tughlaq was the last sultan, okay, of Tughlaq dynasty. Okay.
Tughlaq dynasty.
Yes. Khizr Khan was the governor of Firoz Shah Tughlaq. Okay. And he was, that means Firoz Shah Tughlaq was defeated by Khizr Khan. Okay, Firoz Shah Tughlaq, he joined with Timur. Okay, he joined with Timur and he defeated Khizr Khan and founded the Said dynasty. Children, is it clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Who is the founder of Said dynasty? Who is the founder of
Said dynasty? Khizr Khan.
Khizr Khan.
Whom he defeated?
Timur. Timur.
Feroz Shah Tughlaq.
Yes, ma'am.
Feroz Shah Tughlaq. Okay, see children, before Said dynasty, Said dynasty was ruled over Delhi, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay, so Said Khizr Khan, he defeated Feroz Shah Tughlaq and founded Said dynasty. Okay, and after Khizr Khan, two or three more rulers ruled over Delhi, and the Said dynasty was defeated by Bahlul Lodi. Okay, Bahlul Lodi, and he founded Lodi.
Said dynasty.
Okay, children, Said dynasty. Khizr Khan was the founder of Said dynasty. Okay, he defeated Feroz Shah Tughlaq, the last Sultan of Tughlaq dynasty, and he founded Said dynasty. Okay, and the Said dynasty was defeated by Lodi dynasty. Okay, that means Bahlul Lodi defeated the Said dynasty and they founded Lodi dynasty. Okay, children, is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
After Bahlul Lodi, Sikandar Lodi were there. Okay, Sikandar Lodi was followed by Ibrahim Lodi. Okay, and Ibrahim Lodi was killed in the Battle of Panipat in the year 1526. Okay, in the year 1526, Ibrahim Lodi was killed in the battle and by Babur. Okay, Ibrahim Lodi was defeated by Babur.
The Mughal emperor.
Okay, he founded the Mughal dynasty. So children, we will study. Okay, this is very important. Ibrahim Lodi was defeated in the Battle of Panipat. Panipat is the place name. Okay, and in the year 1526, Ibrahim Lodi was defeated by Babur. Okay, and he founded
Babur Empire.
Okay, Babur founded the Mughal Empire. The first Mughal emperor was Babur. Okay, so children, from in the year 1526, the Delhi Sultanate, started from Qutbuddin Aibak till Ibrahim Lodi. Okay, the Delhi Sultanate period was over. Okay, children, do you understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Children, Qutbuddin Aibak.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, he was Qutbuddin Aibak, 1206. Okay, 1206, he founded the slave dynasty. Okay, 1206 to 1526.
1526.
Yes, this period is referred as Delhi Sultanate. That means Delhi Sultans.
Ma'am,
Delhi Sultans ruled over Indian subcontinent. So this period is referred as Delhi Sultanate. Yes, it started from Qutbuddin Aibak and it ends with the Ibrahim Lodi. Okay, children.
Yes, ma'am.
Let me revise the points which we have discussed, children. After the Tughlaq, the next dynasty who ruled over Delhi was Said dynasty. Okay, who was the founder of Said dynasty?
Khizr Khan
was the founder of Said dynasty, and the Said dynasty was followed by Said dynasty was defeated by Bahlul Lodi.
The first Mughal emperor.
The next ruler. Okay, it was next dynasty followed Said dynasty Babur. was followed by Lodi dynasty. Who is the founder? Bahlul Lodi. Okay. Then after Bahlul Lodi, Sikandar Lodi followed him. Sikandar
Lodi. Ibrahim Lodi. He was killed in the Battle of Panipat in 1526.
Lodi was killed by Babur, okay, Mughal emperor, in the Battle of Panipat in the year 1526. That marked the end of Delhi Sultanate. Okay, that marked the end of Delhi.
Then the Mughal Empire was established.
Yes, and the Mughal era started. Okay, so we will study in detail in the next chapter. We have one more chapter in from history to study, that is about the Mughal Empire. So we will study in detail about the Battle of Panipat in the next chapter. Okay, it is very important. Ibrahim Lodi was defeated. Okay, children, is it clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
From 1206 to 1526. Okay, this period is referred as the Delhi Sultanate period. Okay. And apart from this, okay, so children, during this time, okay, during this 15th and 16th century, some changes, okay, many changes were happened in the society that we have discussed in the first chapter, tracing changes through 1000 years. Okay, so many changes were happened during this time. And among them, the most important change was that a new group of Rajputs. Okay, Rajputs. Okay,
sir, that's
a new ruling. Yes, Rajputs, they become very powerful. And among some dynasties, okay, during this time, okay, so in this period, they were very small, okay, not like an emperor, okay, they were not emperors, very small kingdoms, but they were very powerful, okay, and among the most important was the Sur dynasty.
Sur dynasty.
Yes, if you have the textbook, just open page number 42. Page number 42, last paragraph.
Page number?
42.
Yes, ma'am.
Some of the states established in this period were small but powerful, but extremely well administered. Okay, and Sher Shah Sur, okay, the founder of Sur dynasty, that is Sher Shah Sur, okay, he defeated the Mughal Emperor Humayun. Okay, see children, they are very small. Okay, their kingdom was very small, but they were powerful and well-administered kingdoms. Okay, and Sher Shah Sur, who founded the Sur dynasty, he defeated the Mughal Emperor Humayun, that we will study in the next chapter in detail. Okay, we'll study in detail about this. He defeated the Mughal Emperor Humayun and captured Delhi and established his own dynasty, that is Sur dynasty. Okay, only 15 years this dynasty were in power. Okay, only 15 years they were in power. But they borrowed elements, good elements from Alauddin Khalji. Alauddin Khalji, he was a very effective ruler. So they borrowed some elements from his administration. Okay, and his model, okay, it became a model followed by the great emperors like Akbar when he consolidated the Mughal Empire. That means Sher Shah Sur, his methods, okay, his model, his administration that was followed by the great emperor Akbar. Okay, children, just you need to understand only one thing. During this time, many small kingdoms also become very powerful. Okay, about some people, we have already discussed about Rajputs. And among them, one important was Sur dynasty. Who was the founder of Sur dynasty? Sher Shah Sur.
Sher Shah Sur.
Only 15 years, this dynasty was in power, who ruled over Delhi. And he borrowed elements from Alauddin Khalji. He continued the measures adopted by Alauddin Khalji. Sher Shah Sur also continued the elements from Alauddin Khalji. And his Sher Shah Sur's models, okay, it was followed by even Akbar. Okay, then children, see the last page. See children, the three orders, the Peace of Goad, Knights and the Crusades. Children, this portion, it has given in the textbook. See children, it is not so important. Okay, so children, during this time, the society in France, okay, it was divided into three classes. Okay, it was divided into three classes. Those who prayed, okay, that those who prayed means clergy. Who is clergy? Have you heard about clergy?
Yeah.
Those who lead the prayer and all in churches.
Yes, ma'am.
Ah, churches.
Clergy.
And all
you. The know, leader of the prayer.
Okay, so these people were called. Those who prayed means clergy. Those who fought means nobles.
Nobles.
Ah, yes. And those who tilled the land means?
Farmers.
Ah, yes. Peasants.
Peasants.
Okay, so while the Delhi Sultans were in power in Indian subcontinent, okay, the same time, okay, in France, the society was divided into three classes. Okay, those who prayed, those who fought, and those who tilled the land. That means clergy, nobles, and the peasants. Okay, and this clergy, these people had an important position. The church, okay, it has a dominant role in the society. Okay, so it created a new warrior group called knights or soldiers. Okay, like Rajputs. We have discussed about Rajputs, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay,
yes, ma'am.
The same
ma'am.
Way, were in France, emergence of a new warrior group. They were called as knights. Okay, knights or soldiers. Okay, and do you know, children, what was their duty? The church used them to propagate their idea of peace of God. Okay, and these people, okay, these knights sent them on a campaign against the Muslims who had captured the city of Jerusalem. Jerusalem, do you know what is the importance of that place? Jerusalem?
Amen.
Annette, have you heard this place name, Jerusalem? By using this warrior group, okay, the church made them to fight against the Muslims. Okay, against the Muslims, and a series of war were fought against these Muslims, and these wars were known as crusaders. Children, have you heard about? During this time, France was divided into three sections. The society was divided into three classes: those who prayed, those who fought, and those who tilled the land. Okay, that means peasants. And there were, okay, emergence of a new social or new warrior group. Okay, that were called as knights. Okay, they were
knights.
Knights. The church, and they were, means these people, okay, these knights were sent, okay, to a campaign, to lead a campaign against the Muslims who had captured the city of Jerusalem. Okay, and this led to a series of campaigns. Okay, this were called as crusaders.
The
crusaders. Okay, and
Is
it?
Yes, ma'am.
Let me come.
Yes, ma'am.
The campaigns in the service of God and the church completely altered the status of knights. And these knights become very powerful or very important in the society. Okay. And so that's only, children, about this three orders. Okay. The society was divided into three it was the knights, emergence of a warrior group that were called as knights. Okay.